An extensive leak of financial documents exposes the alleged wealth held by public officials worldwide in offshore accounts. Here's a look into the contents of the so-called Pandora Papers.
A massive leak of financial documents published on Sunday allegedly ties world leaders to secret stores of wealth, from the King of Jordan to associates of Russian President Vladimir Putin. It's being called the Pandora Papers and was published by several major news organizations. The dump of almost 12 million records comes 5 years after the leak known as the Panama Papers, which exposed how money was hidden by the wealthy in ways undetectable by law enforcement agencies. The International Consortium of Investigative Journalists said the new trove of files were linked to dozens of current and former national leaders and amount to the biggest leak of offshore data in history. However, the group did not say how the files were obtained, and Reuters could not independently verify the allegations or documents. Among the claims are that Jordan's King Abdullah, a close ally of the United States, used offshore accounts to spend more than $100 million on luxury homes in the U.S. and U.K. Lawyers representing Abdullah told the consortium he had not, quote, made any use whatsoever of the proceeds of aid or assistance intended for public use. The Washington Post, which is part of the network, reported on the case of Svetlana Krivonogik, a Russian woman who the paper says was in a secret relationship with President Vladimir Putin. The Post says that just weeks after she gave birth to a baby girl in 2003, she became the owner of a Monaco apartment through an offshore company. The Kremlin did not respond to requests for comment. The documents also allege that the Czech Republic's Prime Minister, Andrej Babiš, owned an offshore estate worth $22 million on the French Riviera. The news comes just days before the country's parliamentary elections. Babiš on Sunday denied any wrongdoing while speaking during a televised debate.
Prominent Filipinos are among personalities identified in the Pandora Papers. Owning an offshore account is not prohibited by Philippine law, but government officials are obliged to disclose these types of finances. Willer Chang reports.
More than 900 individuals and companies linked to the Philippines were named in files on offshore accounts based on leaked documents obtained by the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists, or ICIJ. Based on the Philippine Center for Investigative Journalism and Rappler study of the documents called the Pandora Papers, Transport Secretary Arthur Art Tugade has allegedly been keeping an offshore company while in government in the last 8 years, but did not declare it in his list of businesses, in his statements of assets, liabilities, and net worth, or SALEN, as required of public officials. According to Trident Trust records, Tugade is allegedly listed as director at least since 2007 of Solart Holdings Limited, a company based in the British Virgin Islands. His children are listed as co-directors. The PCIJ reports the company was allegedly created for the income of the Tugade family's businesses under the Peris Group of Companies. Company assets worth $1.5 million or 75 million pesos were mentioned, but it is unknown whether this was transferred to Solart. Tugade reportedly disclosed offshore investments worth 57 million pesos as assets since 2012, but no details were provided except that these were acquired in 2003. The PCIJ points out officials may be held liable for not declaring assets, business interests, and financial connections. Tugade has yet to respond to the report. Former head of the Presidential Commission on Good Government and chairperson of the Commission on Elections, Andres Bautista, meanwhile, was listed as incorporator of Bauman Enterprises Limited, a company registered in British Virgin Islands in 2012 and reincorporated in 2017. Bauman was one of the companies mentioned by Bautista's ex-wife Patricia Paz as allegedly owned by Bautista and that he had $1 billion worth of undeclared wealth. Bautista resigned as COMELEC chair in 2017. Bautista told PCIJ Bauman is a shelf company his family purchased upon the advice of the Bank of Singapore, the institution in charge of the offshore income of the Bautista family through private banking. Bautista said he was told that this was normal banking practice to facilitate the family's objective of pooling assets together. Bautista stressed his assets in the company were reported and declared in his SALENs. But the PCIJ pointed out Bauman was never declared as his in his SALENs from 2010 to 2015. Bautista added he has no ill-gotten wealth. The PCIJ explained it is legal for Filipinos to set up offshore accounts, but said that these are still worthy of scrutiny from regulators. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
A former commissioner of the Philippine Tax Bureau says having an offshore company is not a bad thing in itself. But Kim Henares says the problem lies when an offshore company is being used as a means to evade taxes. She adds, as a public officer, Transportation Secretary Arthur Fugade should have declared all of his investments abroad in his salary.
As it is, wala akong masama doon. Nagiging masama na niyan pag ginawa mo yung offshore company. Ito, offshore company. Hindi naman ito offshore. Pag ginawa mo yung offshore company na yan para kasi ayaw mo ilagay sa pangalan mo kasi maaring hindi ka bayad yung mga income mo, marami dyan hindi bayad sa income tax. In itself, wala naman problema kasi kung bayad naman pera mo yan, binayaran mo yung buwis, wala ka naman ginagawang tax evasion or anything, okay lang yun. Ang problema kay Secretary Tugabe is kasi public officer siya. Diba? Pag binaliktad mo yung salin natin sa likod, nakalagay niya, lilista mo doon lahat na kumpanya na shareholder ka.